But the tension was created because you put a timer on the whole situation here that Jack has $9 for the night. And Dan Fogelman is also taking our prior knowledge of these characters and using that to his advantage. We know that Rebecca comes from a family of relative wealth, and that Jack, he's been busting his balls just to make a buck by fixing old ladies' cars and preparing to steal from Ray's. That's why he was there in the first place, right? So you know that they're going to blow through that money because she's thinking, oh, well, you know, I'll take a hot chocolate. Yeah, sure. Why don't you give me a candy apple? Sure. And then you're dreadfully looking at those umbrellas as it rains. And you know he's only got $2 left, right? So this is how he creates tension. It's like the famous Alfred Hitchcock line, right? You put two people at a table talking and it's boring. It's just two people going back and forth. But you put a suitcase with a bomb and a timer underneath that table that the two people don't know about and you, the viewer, knows about. Now you have some tension.
Yep.
Because with every single word, with every single movement that they make, you're like, oh my God.
He only has $2.
And you get the explanation even for you as a viewer at the end.
Mm-hmm.
I can't take a girl go to a carnival and not let her play games.
Yep.
But what am I going to do?
Yep.
That whole thing was fantastic.